Hello everyone, welcome to Aptitude Jab. This is a question which says that a person has four ATM cards A, B, C, and D, and each card has a four digit PIN. Okay, and the table gives the number of times each of the digits from 0 to 9 were used in these PINs. So there are four eight cards and four digit PIN, so 4 into 4, 16 digits will be used. Right, 16 digits, total 16 digits. This gives you the number of times these digits were used. So 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 11, 14, 15, 16, right? So that is what is given to you, right? And now certain conditions are given using which we have to find out the pins of all the cards. Okay, so first thing is given that all pins are multiples of 25, no pins has any digit repeated, and no pin starts with 0. Pin of card A is 2 times of pin of card B plus 25. Pin of card C is 2 times of pin of card D plus 100. The first two digits of pin of card A is equal to 2 times the first digits of pin of card B. And the sum of digits of pin of card C is 15. So using these conditions, we have to determine what is the pin of each of these cards. Right. So the biggest condition in this case is all pins are multiples of 25. That reduces our case by manifold. So if all pins are multiples of 25, you know that multiples of 25, they end in like 0, 0, 2, 5, 5, 0 or 7, 5. So these are the last two digits. Now it has any digit repeated, so 0, 0 is not possible. So the last two digits of these pins will be 2, 5, 5, 0 or 7, 5, right? So this gives us a hint that okay, at least one thing is known to us. Okay, now we will look at these two statements. Right, let's first look at these statement. Pin of card A is 2 into pin of card B plus 25. So I am talking about the last two digits. Suppose the last two digits of B are 50. Okay, let's start with 2, 5, 2, 5, 5, 0 and 7, 5. So if it is 2, 5, 2, 5 into 2 is 50, 50 plus 2, 5 is 7, 5. So A will end in 7, 5. If B, the last two digits are 50. So 50 into 2 is 0, 0, right? Let's say if it is, just taking an example, 1, 3, 5, 0 into 2, that will be 2, 7, 0, 0. Then you add 25, you will get 2, 7, 2, 5. So if it is 50, the last two digits of A will be 25. Similarly, if it is 75, 75 into 2 is 150. So last two digits 50, then it will be again 75. So what we notice is the last two digits of A are 75, 25 or 75. So last digit of A is definitely 5. Okay. Similarly, let us take this condition. Pin of card C is 2 into pin of card D plus 100. So we will take D and C. So if I take D, last two digits 2, 5, 5, 0 or 7, 5. 2, 5 into 2 is 50, and 100 will make it 50 only, right? 50 will make it 100, right? 100 plus 100 will be 0, 0. 7, 5 will make it 50 and 100 will make it 50 only. Now we know that this case is not possible because last two digits cannot be 0, 0. So that gives us that last two digits of C are 50. Okay. And last digit of D is 5. Okay. Thus far it has been used. Okay. Now we have an important thing that the sum of the first two digits of pin of card A is 2 times the first two digits of pin of card B. Now it's a valuable thing, and if you pay attention to it, you will be able to figure out. I'm writing three cases, right? I'm taking three hypothetical numbers. Let's say that's what I took, 1, 3, 5, 0. Let me take 1, 3, 2, 5 and 1, 3, 7, 5. So B, this is, suppose this is B, I mean just taking an example, suppose this is B, then what is A? A is 2 times of B plus 25, 2, 6, 5, 0, plus 25 will give me 2675 into 2 will give me 2750 plus 25 will give me 2775. Okay. Now, if you see this condition, the first two digits of PIN of card A is 2 times the first two digits of PIN of card B. First two digits, 2 times yes. First two digits, 2 times no. First two digits, 2 times no. Now, why is this happening? Why is this thing happening? This thing is happening because if the last two digits of B are 50 or 75, when you multiply them by 2, that will generate a carry. That will make it 100 or 150, right? That will make a carry. So the last two digits will no longer, the first two digits will no longer remain the same. Okay. So if the last two digits are 50 or 75, it will generate a carry and first two digit will increase by 1. So that means we can eliminate these two possibilities. So we are left with only one possibility, that last two digits of B are 25 and last two digits of A are 75. Okay. So this is what we get thus far. Now we have to, we have one condition that the sum of digits of PIN of card C is 15. Okay, lot of possibilities in there. So we have utilized these statements. Okay, now what we can do is, let us see some more conditions. So 25 we already know. Now it says no PIN starts with a 0. Okay, so this helps us solve our question, because if no PIN starts with 0, so 0 cannot come in these positions. Clear? 0 cannot come in these positions. Also, C cannot have a 0 because 0 is already used in C. Next condition is, suppose I put 0 here, right? Suppose I put, it is saying that the first two digits of PIN of card A is 2 times the first two digits of PIN of card B. Suppose I put 0 here, let us say if I put 30, this will become 60, right? So I cannot put 0 in B. I cannot put 0 in, basically in A I cannot have 0, because suppose if I put in B, then obviously this will become 0. Okay, so I cannot put 0 in B. Now suppose we think that let's say it is what if it is 90, just taking an example, right? That means it has to be 45. So if it is 0, it has to be a multiple of 5, right? It has to be a multiple of 5, because 5 into 2 will give you, ending in 0 means it should be a multiple of 5. Now 5 is already used, so you cannot use 5 here. So that means we cannot use 0 in either of the places. Okay, we cannot use 0 in A and B also, right? Okay, so only D is the number which will contain 0. Now where can it contain 0? It cannot contain 0 here, because it will be either 25 or 75, right? Last two digits are 25 or 75. So 0 cannot come here. So 0 will come here. Okay, so this statement that no PIN starts with a 0 helped us reduce the cases and helped us solve it. Okay, now the next thing is some hit and trial. Okay, now we will do some hit and trial. That we know that the sum of digits of PIN of card C is 15, right? Suppose if I take 10 here, just saying that if I take 10 here, this will be 2000 something, right? So if I take 1025 into 2 plus 100, right? 2050 plus 1 is 2150, right? So I am not able to add a total of 15. If I put 20 also, 20 will make it 41, right? Not able to put 30 also, not possible, right? It will be 60 or 61, 61 or 62. I cannot make it. I cannot put 50. I can put 40, right? If I make 4025 into 2, that will be 8050 plus 100 will make it 8150, right? I am getting the digit sum as 14. If I take another possibility, that is 4075, because this can be 25 or 75, Okay, d can be 2, 5 or 7, 5. If I take 4, 0, 7, 5 into 2, I will get 8, 1, 5, 0. I'll add 100. I'll get 8, 2, 5, 0. Okay, so this makes everything clear, right? 8, 2, 5, 0. Okay, one thing that you have to again check is if the digits are available. Okay, the digit should be available. So 2, 0 we have utilized both. 2 has been utilized once, right? So if I make it 4075 and I take 8250, that is possible because 12 is available. Okay, so 8250, that is the only possibility which will fit in. Now how will we find A and B? Let us find the digits that are remaining. So zeros have been utilized, twos have been used, so two twos are gone, three is not used, 4 is used, 5, how many 5s have been used? 1, 2, 3, 4. So all 4 5s have been used. 6 has not been used. 7s, both 7s have been used. Talking of 8s, 1 8 has been used, 1 8 remains. Okay. Now the digits left with us for to be used in these 4 places are 1, 3, 6 and 8. And what we know the relation between them, the pin of the first two digits of pin of card A is 2 times the first two digits of pin of card B. So we have to think of two numbers that this number is double of this number. So only one possibility you will get, which is 18 and 36. Isn't it? 36 is 2 times of 18. This will be 18. This will be 36. Okay, so these are the 4 pins, right? So this was a difficult one, right? You have to think a lot. You have to think in terms of numbers. You should know these properties of numbers, especially the things that you had to think was one. Okay, this was easy thing to think, right? I would say that this was something easy that should have clicked, right? Then something that was moderately difficult was to think this, right, last two digits, and this was a difficult thing to think ki whether it will be 25 or 75. So if you are able to think all these things, you could do this question, and it does require a lot of time to solve such a question. What is the pin of card B? So card B is 1825. What is the sum of digits of pin of card A? 9 plus 12, 21. The pin of which card contains the digit 4? So 4 is in card D. Which of the following statements is or are correct? The second digit of all pins are different. Yes, that is correct. And the last digit of all pins is 5 is incorrect. So only 1 is correct. So I hope you enjoyed this set, and do mention the time taken by you to solve this question. Thanks for watching this video.